Hey guys, in this video I want to show you my favorite rappel extension. But at first, some history behind it. When I started rappelling, at the beginning I had the rappel device directly on my tie-in point and then prusik cord above. Yeah, why a prusik? A prusik is a friction hitch which adds up security. If you let your hands go or something happens, the prusik will catch and then you have all your weight on the prusik. Then, after some time, I was thinking about how to improve the system, so I added an extension. So the rappel device is here and the prusik cord is underneath. Now, when I let my hands free or something happens, only the weight underneath the rappel device, which is lower than above, is added to the prusik. Then it's easier to loosen it again and to continue rappelling. In mountain sports and alpine sports, it's like a standard to extend your rappel, so feel free to use Google search or even here on YouTube you can search for rappel extension and you will find a lot of videos about extending your rappel device. Even for a technical user, this is quite helpful in my opinion. And yeah, I have a system which I want to show you. It's this one. I have also shown it on Instagram previously. It's a tube. A long dog bone, or however it's called, like it's from Petzl, some webbing and two carabiners by Austria Alpine, one with slider outlock and one is this 50-50 carabiner. And then also a prusik cord, and this time quite short one, but it's stitched. This is by Edelrid, aramid cord, and I can attach this to this lower carabiner and I'll have my setup like that. Yeah, what's good about the extension is the device is up here and you can use both hands for the brake rope. I prefer a tube above all these rappel aids or figure of eights or the manta hitch because this doesn't make wrinkles in the rope. Ringles? I'm not sure if it's the right word, but I think you know what I mean, because here the rope goes down straight, one turn, and comes out straight. On almost all other things, like the manta hitch or the figure 8 rappel device, it twists the rope. Okay, here I have some rope, 11mm static line by Teufelberger. I just add this to the tube in high friction mode. If I use it the other way, it's a low friction mode. I would use this when I use two strands of rope, for example. Now up here is the slider outlock. So it's an outlocking carabiner, I don't have to screw. And now here on this 50-50 carabiner, you have two chambers. And in the upper one, I have my prusik cord. I can add this to the rope with two wraps or even three reps if I want. Yeah, it's quite a short one. I could even use a longer one. And then I can add this back to this carabiner. Now, what's cool about this system is, with the prusik cord, I can go hands-free and work on my weapon or take a rest. It's even safer if you still hold this, because when you get accidentally with your arms on the prusik, it can slide down, or when you get on a rock or a branch or whatever. So it's even safer to still hold the rope, but you don't have to hold your weight the whole time. And now, since the weight is here, goes through the rappel device, the weight down here is quite low. Even if I jump in the rope, this prusik is quite easy to loosen or to untighten. Yeah, I could even use this without auto prusik. Now, I'm sure some of you guys ask, yeah, why don't you attach this just to your tie-in point and the prusik on the leg loop? Yeah, it's old school to do it like that. There can accidents happen. For example, when you lift up your leg and the prusik is only on your leg loop, it can happen that the prusik comes too close to the rappel device and then it can unlock or open up and then you fall to death. Yeah, with this I can change from left hand to right hand really easy, and when I'm down on the ground I can give some slack for the others to follow, and then one move and I'm out of the system. Sure, I cannot leave the system when it's weighted, but with this 50-50 carabiner from Osteoalpine, it's really easy to open it up and get out of the system or get into the system. So someone can prepare this for you, and then you just have to come here, click, Prusik, tube, extension, everything is on the 50-50 carabiner, and it's really easy to use and to get to get out of the system. Yeah, that's my favorite system at the moment. Yeah, because the tube gives a lot of options. If you also do climbing, you can belay someone. If you use two strands of rope, you can also belay someone, or you can rappel on one strand of rope or two strands of rope. You can even use this with an auto-blocking function, and when belaying the seconds, you can also use it with auto-blocking function or in guide mode. Just feel free to check out YouTube and watch all these Alpine Sport videos to get some more information about what a tube is. By the way, this black tube is by BlackSafe. It's completely black, and they do some nice ropes related equipment completely in black. Okay, that's it, guys. So this is the Rappel extension I'm using. I know there are some special quick detach solutions for tactical users, which are also capable of being opened under tension. Yes, but they are sometimes pricey. This is a quite multi-purpose, easy to do, easy to use device or setup I really like. So feel free to comment what you think about this and how do you rappel. Thank you for watching and see you next time. Bye.